Hi. In this video, I want to talk about implementing an interface. When would I want to implement an interface? When I want my class to provide a functionality described in an interface, and when I want the objects of my class to establish an is-a relationship with that interface type. Let's look at an example. Let's say I have 5 circles of different sizes. I want to be able to sort an array of circles. What I can do is implement comparable e. Now in the case of a circle, the e would be my circle, and when my class circle implements comparable circle, an order is established and an array of circles can be sorted. Now let's look how we implement an interface. To implement an interface, we need to do 2 things. In our class header, we need to add the keyword implements and the interface name. And then we have to make sure that every single method declared in an interface is implemented, or that I declare my class abstract. Here is an example. Let's say I have a public class, class 1, and it implements interface 1. Notice the keyword implements and interface 1 right next to the header of my class. Let's look at an example. Here I prepared a class called circle. It has 1 field radius, a parameterized constructor that initializes radius, a getter, a setter, and the overwritten 2-string method. I just print out C colon for circle followed by the radius. Let's have a look at circle app. In circle app, I declare an array of circles called circles, and I instantiate it with 4 circles of different sizes. And then I'm going to print out my array of circles. I do this using the 2-string method of class arrays. So let's run it. You can see it prints out circle 1.5, 3, 2.1, 0.7. What I would like to do next is to sort my array, then print it out. So I'm going to do that. I say arrays, sort, and I'm going to sort my circles. All looks good. All looks good now. I'm going to run. And here I have an exception. A class cast exception. Let's see what the problem is. I'm going here to line 14 because it specified line 14 as the place that caused the problem. So I'm looking at sort. And when I look at sort, I can find out that all elements in the array must implement a comparable interface. The compiler didn't catch it. But at runtime, Java realized that my circle objects were not comparables. My circle did not implement comparable. We have to fix that. So I'm going to my, let's just clear that and go back to circle and let's implement comparable. So here I use the keyword implements and comparable. Comparable comes as a generic interface. In new code, it's always preferable to use the generic version, so we use a comparable of circle. And as I do that, I get a red wiggly line. And when I roll over it, it reminds me that we declared our class as a class that implements comparable, but we have not provided the body for the abstract classes in the interface yet. And Eclipse helps me out. It says, would you like me to add unimplemented methods? I like that because this way I don't need to memorize all the signatures. It helps me out. It gives me the override annotation. It also knows that the interface comparable has exactly 1 method called compareTo with 1 parameter. If it's a comparable of circle, my parameter is of type circle, and it returns an integer. Say, good, I want to implement it. Interfaces specify 2 things for a method. The signature and corresponding semantics. What should my method really do? Before I can implement compare to, I need to find out what exactly is the specified semantics. I'm rolling over here and I can look up more information. It tells me all kinds of things about compare to besides my signature. It tells me what it should return. You can read this on your own. But it basically tells me if my circle is greater than the other circle, I return a positive number. If my circle is less than the other circle, I return a negative number. If they're the same, I return zero. It also specifies that I have to throw a null pointer exception if the argument passed happens to be null. So let's do that. I start here by checking for null. I say, well, if O, I don't like the name O, I change this to other. That seems a little bit more clear to me. So I say, well, if other is null, then throw a new null pointer exception. Throw new null pointer exception. And I'm going to write some message. I say, can't compare with null. And now that I know my circle is not null, I do the actual comparison. I compare my radius with the radius of the circle passed. So I say, if radius is greater than the other radius, then return something positive, let's say 1. If radius is less than the other radius, then return minus 1. Otherwise, I'm returning 0. So let's try again. Let's go back to my circle app. We still have array sort here. I'm going to run. And this time, my circles are nicely sorted. One comment for those of you who like math, I could exchange this whole code segment here with a single line. I could also say return int math signum. And my signum from radius minus other radius. I'm subtracting the other radius from my radius. If it is smaller, signum gives me minus 1. If it's greater, signum gives me 1. If it's the same, signum gives me 0. However, signum returns a double value, so I still have to cast to an integer. Let's run it again. And you can see we have the same results. At this point, we looked at an example of how to declare a class that implements an interface. So we declared class circle that implemented comparable circle. A class can also extend a superclass explicitly, plus, in addition, implement an interface. Or it could implement multiple interfaces. In that case, the interfaces would be separated with a comma. One thing I want to point out is that every class extends exactly one superclass. This is true for all Java classes except for object, because even if a class does not explicitly extend the superclass, it extends object. A class can implement zero or multiple interfaces. When a class implements an interface, the objects of the class have an is-a relationship to that interface. That has interesting implications, and we're going to talk about that in the next video.